There's a lady at work.
Yes.
Whose last name is, so I work with HR a lot, and this woman's last name is Fur, F-U-H-R. And every time we say it, we giggle. I work in HR, and her last name is F-U-H-R. Okay.
My license plate is True 269.
Is what?
True 269.
Okay. Yeah, but okay. All right. Rolling quite along. We get some.
Reset the brain.
Here. Right. I appreciate that. Refocus, shifting. So, what were some of the things that people put down as things that they do to?
You were too busy talking.
Relieve stress or stress reduction techniques. Talk with who?
The table neighbor.
Your table neighbor. Okay.
That's a stress reliever.
What do other people say? What are some things you do?
Our teachers want me to like study for 15 minutes a day instead of trying to cram before the test or whatever.
Yeah, what's with that? What's with this whole binge studying thing?
The people I think don't study at all.
Huh?
It doesn't make sense.
It doesn't make sense. People think that that's cool.
Then you go to class and you're exhausted because you've had an all-nighter studying and you can't remember anything.
I don't do that.
Yeah.
I don't study at all.
You don't study at all?
At all.
Do you just absorb information or?
I remember like the writing on the board and
you don't study math.
No, if you can write down the problem, it's the way of doing it. That's all you got to remember.
Yeah.
And everything else is just the same, just on how you look at it. You just got to interpret it the right way.
Yeah. It's real funny because that whole binge studying thing, I think, stems from another binge tradition, which is binge drinking. Right? Like, people really think that they'll have a good time if they cram it all in at once. Right? I remember doing that. I mean, myself. And back in the day, it was, we had MD 2020, Mad Dog 2020, grape with a straw. Because you didn't want to get any oxygen in there. You wanted straight liquor. Right? And they call that stuff Mad Dog because it made you a mad dog. Right? But for whatever reason, we thought that that was really effective. And, like, that made me really cool, you know? And, yeah.
It's cheap.
It was way cheap.
It's like buying Boons.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's how you start it. That's how you start. You start with Boons Farm. Then you move up to Mad Dog or Wild Irish Rose. I don't know if that was in this part of the country or not. And then you'd move up to Brass Monkey or Fuzzy Nabel. She's singing a song. Brad Monkey. The Funky Monkey. Aye. Oh, sorry.
I know the Wild Irish.
Yep, and then, you know, but when we were in college, the thing was Colt 45 and Old English 800, a lot of malt liquor. I don't know why folks I was hanging around like malt liquor, but, you know.
What is malt liquor like? What's the
You know what? I really don't know.
I think higher alcohol concentration on it.
Okay.
It's cheap. It's cheap. The bottle of barrel type stuff. They just dump a bunch of alcohol into it more
to get you where you want to go.
Exactly, right. It's cheap beer, and you know, it's
become a what they call them, weekend warriors. They call them, I don't know, some kind of warriors when you get liquid courage, you know, because you do stuff then you wouldn't normally do, right? But I think that's interesting because nobody ever sets out at the beginning of the night to say, I want to look horrible, and I want to stick my face in a toilet for the rest of the night. Nobody ever wakes up in the morning and says that.
Right? Can you say nobody? Because I got some really retarded friends that
they enjoy that kind of stuff?
I am going to get so wasted tonight that tomorrow I am going to be sick, throwing up, and I don't want to move. I'm going to have that much fun tonight, they say.
Wow. Wow. Well, I guess I can't say nobody.
I can't do it.
Right.
They've lost a few parties.
My friends aren't exactly the brightest bulbs. Right. At least some of them aren't.
But the point of the story is, when we go back to talking about this cramming thing, cramming doesn't typically give us the results that we're looking for that same reason that binge drinking doesn't, right? Because we overload our system, it's more than what we can handle, and we typically don't perform as best we could, right? And so taking those small pieces and doing 15 minutes at a time or whatever time frame works for you over a long period of time works a whole lot better than kind of that binge studying thing. It's also true, like with diets, right? Sometimes people will say, I'm going to be on this grapefruit diet, and so that's all I'm going to eat is a grapefruit. And your system said, what does your system say to that? He said, yeah, that's exactly what your system says, right? It says, yeah, right. So you lose the stuff you're looking for, but as soon as you get off of that thing, what happens? Your body says, you've starved me for this much amount of time, giving me some old goofy grapefruit. Now I want it all back. And so it goes back and it gets everything and sometimes more, right? So that whole binge mentality or cramming mentality is not a good thing. And people will even trick themselves and say, well, I work best under pressure. You know, I do my best work, blah, 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 blah.
Baloney. That's all they know how to do.
That's all they know how to do because that's all that they've done when?
Their whole
in
life.
The past, right? And so they're taking their past experiences and bringing them forward. And so, you know, we're not going to do that. We're not going to be those crammers. What are some other things that people do to relieve stress in terms of having some academic stress?
Well, you could, if you're not sure how you're doing a problem or something, take the practice test or do practice assignments just to...
Yeah, do practice assignments. Go over and over these types of assignments until you get comfortable with them, right? Because part of the stress is being outside of your comfort zone and not being where you feel comfortable. I didn't want to say that again, but it's kind of redundant. But yeah, it's redundant, like I said it again and over one more time, repeating it as if I didn't say it the first time. Again, and keep going on the same stuff again.
Done now?
Yes. All right. So what else? What are some other things?
Ask for help. Yeah, that's awesome.
Take a step away. Just walk away, clear your mind, and then just come back to it. All right, I'm not frustrated anymore. I'm not...
Yep, take that break. Ask for help. It's so funny. I work with a young man, and he... He's 15, and he feels like he has to have an answer for everything, even if he doesn't know, right? So he's constantly making up stuff, and he's using words that don't make sense for what we're talking about because he's trying to be smarter than he is. And so I've been working with him with this phrase, and the phrase is, Andre, I don't know, can you tell me? Right? Because I ask him a question, he's like, well, you know, what I think is blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, he's like, okay, Andre, I don't know. Can you tell me? Right? Because what's the problem with not learning that skill?
I think if you know everything, you're not going to learn anything.
Yeah. If you already think you know, you're not going to learn. One of the greatest lessons I learned was that I don't know as much as I think I do. And the more that I find out, the less I figure out that I know about different stuff all the time. Because I think you think you have people figured out, then they surprise you. You're like, really? Oh my goodness. Like, for example, I think I told you about my grandmother. I used to think, God rest her soul, I thought that my grandmother was really nasty.
Like dirty?
Like dirty nasty, right? Because we would go over there and like she'd have fruits and vegetables that had mold on them still in the refrigerator or cheese that had mold on it. And so what my grandmother would say is, cut the mold off. And I was like, are you? Or she'd have, you know, a little bit of mold in the jelly or something, and she'd like take the mold out. And I was like, right? And so I never wanted to eat over grandma's house. You know, it was like, if you drop us off, can we just stay for a little while, you know, so we don't have to eat? But one of the things I didn't think about was why she did that, or why that became a part of her routine and her habits. And what I discovered was that she grew up during the Depression. And so during the Depression, if you had some mold on your onion, at least you had
an onion,
right? And so that's something that transferred into her other stuff. And I was like, oh, and so I had to apologize to God and to her for, you know, talking bad about her behind her back, you know. But those are some things that, you know, I realized. What are some other things that folks wrote down as stress relievers or that you could use as a part of a plan? What's that?
You can write your planner.
You can write in your planner.
What you have to do and what's important and what's not that important.
Yeah. And it's really funny for me, I have to check my calendar every day because what I've decided to do was not to remember what I'm supposed to do every day.
Like if you go to bed at night and you've got all these things, I gotta do this. I will get out of bed, go and find some paper, write it down. So that I can just let it go.
Yep. Then I'm free.
That's what I do.
Right? Because otherwise, I'm laying in bed and I'm like, okay, all right, got to do this, got to do that, remember. And then I'm working in my sleep and I'm like, and then I got to get up and work again. So I just spent 24 hours working on something that should only have taken
me by the office.
And I don't get paid. They don't pay me that much to work 24 hours a day. Right? So there's that. I wanted to spend a little bit of time talking about the rubric for your paper, because we're not talking about the paper anymore, but I did want to talk about the rubric, which is this piece of paper right here. So people are very clear about what we're looking at. So this is the rubric that you will score yourself on. So when you turn your paper in, this is what you'll turn in with your paper. And you will circle, highlight, denote, put an X in each of the categories that applies to what you think your score is, okay? So for 5 points, let's see, it's a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's 25 points total. So if you get 5 points in all of those categories, then you would have an A. If you do not wish to have an A, you have other choices that you can make, all right? So, but to get an A, you need to have a clear vision with future accomplishments with details. And so when I talk about those details, instead of just saying I have a house, the details would be I have a red house in the mountains of Colorado, and with a stone porch and so forth and so on, all right? So that level of detail. 15 goal and goal statements, and the goal statements have to have words, want workable measures, and again, that's that time, date, or percentage of change, what you'll change in that. For your chart, you'll have a minimum of 8 actions and tasks. I think I may have adjusted that did I say 5? Okay. So we'll adjust that according to this matrix. And then 15 positive, present tense, emotional payoff, no comparing, personal statements that are your affirmations. And then lastly, making sure that the cover page meets the APA standards, which we will find in our Wadsworth. Do that.
That's an automatic 5 points right there. It's cover exactly what the page is. Name, teacher's name.
Right? Yep, he's so smart. This is why he's in this class.
Show us how street.
No, because we're all that smart. Yeah. Birds of a feather. All right. So, any questions? All right. What I'd like for you to do for homework.
Oh.
Oh, come on. I want you to look at page 153 to 163 in those success principles books and bring them back next week.
What pages?
153 to 163. And we're talking about feedback. Talking about feedback. So page 153 to 163, just 10 pages. You can knock that out right before you go to bed, in the morning, before you take a shower. Do not use these in the bathroom. That is nasty.
That is gross.
That's kind of gross. All right. Please turn in your stress plans, those 10 things, and I will see you next week. Thank you so much. It has been a pleasure to teach you.
You ain't done yet. Still have many more classes.
We've got a couple more classes.
What else? Do you teach other classes here? Or is it
no, this is it. This is it.
Broaden your horizons, man.
Man, look.
It's only, it's work. It's easy.
I don't think they could handle me in other classes.